Dear students, in the last class we are solving the problems on Nyquist plot. Today we are going to see Nyquist stability criterion. It states the Nyquist stability criterion states that the number of encirclements about the critical point -1 + j0 must be equal to number of poles of characteristic equation, which are nothing but open loop transfer function poles in the right half of S plane. Repeat the statement. Nyquist stability criterion states that the number of encirclements about the critical point -1 + j0 must be equal to number of poles of characteristic equation, which are nothing but open loop transfer function poles in the right half of S plane. Let me see the problem. Let me analyze this Nyquist stability criterion with the help of an example. Draw the Nyquist plot for g of S h of S equal to 1 divided by S into S plus 1. S into S plus 1. First, draw the pole 0 diagram, that is for 1 divided by S into S plus 1, draw the pole 0 diagram. To draw the pole 0 diagram, how many poles are there? One pole at origin, one more pole at minus 1. The magnitude of it is 1 divided by omega into under root of omega square plus 1. The angle is minus 90 degrees minus tan inverse of omega. At omega equal to 0 plus, the magnitude is infinity and angle is minus 90 degrees. At omega equal to plus infinity, the magnitude is 0, the angle is minus 180 degrees. See, to draw this, the ending direction is clockwise. The starting angle is clockwise. So, for drawing this, the magnitude is infinity at omega equal to 0 plus. So, the mean somewhere else here starts from here. And where it has to be? Minus 90 degrees. Why we need to take it as only at this side? Since the angle is minus 90 degrees, we need to start from here. And magnitude is infinity, somewhere else here, infinity will be there. At omega equal to plus infinity, the magnitude is 0 at an angle of minus 180 degrees. You can observe here at this point the magnitude is 0, but the angle minus 180 degrees. Yeah. Section 2. At omega equal to 0 minus, this allows the section 1, section 2, section 3, section 4. That is, this is from here, from plus j0 to j infinity, plus j infinity section 1. Section 2 is, this is the section 2. Section 3 is, this is the section 3. And section 4 is, this is the section 4. At omega equal to 0 minus, what is the magnitude and angle? Magnitude is infinity, angle is plus 90 degrees. At omega equal to 0 plus, the magnitude is infinity, angle is minus 90 degrees. How we can find that? How we will be getting this as, see, if we are having plus j0 minus j0, the pole is 1 by s, the s value will be taking it as plus j0, 1 divided by plus j0. Whenever we are having plus j0, the angle is 1 divided by plus 90 degrees. Why we are getting it as here plus 90 degrees? Tan inverse of imaginary part divided by real part. Imaginary part is 0, so tan inverse of 0 is 90 degrees, so you will be getting it as plus 90 degrees. So if you bring this numerator, then it becomes minus 90 degrees. Whereas here, for minus j0, 1 by s, then that if 1 by s equal to 1 divided by minus j0, if this that can be equal to 1 divided by minus 90 degrees, if you bring this minus 90 degrees numerator, it becomes plus 90 degrees. Similarly, suppose if you're having in three poles at origin, in that case, then the angle will be 1 by s cube. So, that equal to 1 divided by plus j0 whole cube, that equal to 1 divided by 3 into 90 degrees, that equal to minus 270 degrees. Minus j0, 1 by s cube, then 1 divided by minus j0 whole cube, that equal to minus 90 degrees into 3. If this goes to numerator, then it becomes plus 270 degrees. If it is a plus 270 degrees, plus 270 degrees, then it starts from here. It starts from here and it encircles us in the clockwise direction as like this and ends here. So in this case, for one pole, omega equal to infinity plus 90 degrees, at omega equal to 0 minus, the magnitude is infinity, the angle is plus 90 degrees. At omega equal to 0 plus, the magnitude is infinity and angle is minus 90 degrees. So the path will be like this. Just take here a note is very important. The number of infinite radius half circles equal to the number of poles at origin. If zeros are exist at origin, then there is no infinite radius half circles. The infinite radius half circles should always be in the clockwise direction. Here, I repeat the note. The number of infinite radius half circles equal to number of poles at origin. If zeros are exist at origin, then there is no infinite radius half circles. The infinite radius half circles always should be in clockwise direction. Section 3 is a mirror image of section 1 about the real axis. Now if this is the section 1 path, section 3 is the mirror image of this about the real axis. Section 4, to find the section 4, at omega equal to plus j infinity, the magnitude is plus infinity, so the magnitude is 0. At omega equal to minus j infinity, the magnitude is 0. So neglect section 4 because the magnitudes are 0, then complete the Nyquist plot. Then if you complete the Nyquist plot, the infinite radius half circles should... To complete the Nyquist plot, the infinite radius half circles should be start at where mirror image ends and infinite radius half circles should be end at where actual polar plot started. The number of open loop poles P equal to 0. So n equal to P, then closed loop system is stable. And the complete Nyquist plot will be like this. That is, it starts from here. The first is like this, path 1. Path 3 is this. And where it has to start from here. And it has to end, these encirclements has to end at where the polar plot has been started. It has to end here. So the system is said to be stable. The next problem is g of s h of s equal to 10 divided by s plus 1. So first draw the pole 0 plot. That means one pole is present here at minus 1. The magnitude and angle values at omega equal to 0 is 10 at an angle is 0. At omega equal to infinity, the magnitude is 0 and angle is minus 90 degrees. Ending direction is clockwise direction. Starting direction is clockwise direction. So once if you know the polar plot of drawing the polar plot, you need to draw the exactly mirror image of a real axis. So P equal to 0, M equal to P, so the system is said to be stable. The next one is G of S H of S equal to 10 divided by S plus 1 into S plus 2. At omega equal to 0, the magnitude is 5 and angle is 0 degrees. At omega equal to infinity, the magnitude is 10, angle is minus 180 degrees. First, to draw the pole 0 plot, one pole is present at here somewhere else, one more pole is present at somewhere at minus 2. Ending direction is clockwise direction, starting direction is clockwise direction. And if you draw this polar plot, it has to start from here and it has to end at minus 180 degrees with a magnitude of 0. So draw the mirror image of this and you will be getting, and find the number of poles enclosed, P equal to 0, so the system is stable. G of S, H of S equal to 10. 10 divided by S square into S plus 1 into S plus 2. Draw the pole 0 diagrams. At omega equal to 0, the magnitude is infinity and angle is minus 180 degrees. At omega equal to infinity, the magnitude is 0 and angle is minus 360 degrees. Ending direction is clockwise direction. Starting direction is clockwise direction. See here, at omega equal to 0, angle is minus 180 degrees, the magnitude should be infinity. At omega equal to infinity, the magnitude is 0 and angle is minus 360 degrees, means we need to come like this. So the number of poles on the RHS side is P equal to 0. So N is not equal to P, so the system is said to be unstable. N equal to P minus Z, N is minus 2, 0 minus Z, Z equal to 2. So the closed loop poles which are on the right half of S plane, so the system is said to be unstable. The next problem is G of S, H of S equal to K divided by S plus 1 into S plus 2 into S plus 3. At omega equal to 0, the magnitude is K by 6, angle is 0 degrees. At omega equal to infinity, the magnitude is 0, angle is minus 270 degrees. Ending direction is clockwise direction, starting direction is clockwise direction. This is the path, intersection point with the real axis. To find this intersection point with the real axis, make the imaginary terms, that is r powers of s to 0. So omega equal to root 11 you will be getting. The magnitude is k by 60 you will be getting. According to the magnitude condition, k by 60 should be 1. K by 60 should be equal to 1. So k value will be lying in between minus 6 to 60. If p equal to 0, it's unstable. K by 60 is greater than 1, k is greater than 60. So n equal to p minus z, minus 2 equal to 0 minus z, z equal to 2. The closed loop zeros which are on the right half of S plane. To find all these things, to find the k value, the procedure for this, to find the range of k value, first consider the magnitude equal to 1 at the intersection point with plus or minus 180 degrees. Shift the intersection point towards minus infinity by considering the magnitude is greater than 0, and find the number of encirclements by considering the critical point is inside the loop and check the stability. Again, shift the intersection point towards the origin by considering the magnitude is less than 1 and check the number of encirclements by considering the critical point is outside the loop. Observe the magnitude with 0 degrees axis, which must be always greater than 1. This is the procedure you need to follow to find the range of k value. Find the stability by using Nyquist plot.